Hi there. Now, I'm going to present a demo video of prototype application we have available, which offer more than many great on-demand multi-services in a single application, including taxi rides, food, grocery, medicine, courier services, on-demand delivery, and handyman services. And in this application, you will be getting customer application, agent application, admin panel, supplier panel, along with driver's application. So the user interface. So once a user or a customer, I could say here, is downloading this application. After downloading this application, can sign up through their social accounts such as Facebook and Google. And after signing up, the customer will be landing on this page. This is a landing page which we have available for our clone application. So here on the very first of the screen, if you will see on the top of it, there is a location tab. So we are using a geocoding system in the back in the back end of this application, because of which automatically locations get detected. Or you also have other option to select or choose the addresses above. You can just search your location by typing it here. So after the location, underneath to that, you will be able, are able to see the banners. So these are the banners which we have available, okay? And after that, we have a list of services available, such as grocery, sanitizer, mask, food, energy, home, beauty, Burger King size, ambulance, cab booking, and pickup. I'm gonna cover each and everything. I'm gonna make you understand like how we can actually place order for grocery items, how we can place order for food items, and how we can do it for other etc. things. And if we will scroll it down, you will be able to see the offers we have available, the promos, and the owner of the application can actually do it easily just by logging in to the web panels. I will be coming to that thing, and I will be covering that as well. So here we can see in daily deals on demand grocery delivers 50% discount order now, and Chick Blast up to 70% off. So that's are the offers we have available. So let's begin with the placing an order for grocery items. So look, I am clicking it here on this tab. So if customer will be clicking it here on the grocery app, he will be landing out he will be landing to this screen home page of the grocery application here, where the person will be able to see the banners on the very first. And the customer will be able to see the options. Number one is delivery, and second is self pickup. So let's explore the delivery first. So after delivery and self pickup, we have the banners available here, which also tell us the discounts and offers we have available. So as a customer, if customer is actually scrolling it down, he can see recommended stores and special offers again on the banners, and these are the stores listed on the application. So let's start with the Govind store. I have clicked on it, so I can actually see, as a customer, I can see like what are the items is being available and listed by this specific Govind store. Let's place an order. Let's see how it works. So for example, I just need two items of this and two item of this. There also one more option as menu. So if somebody or if some customer want to have a look on the detailed list of the menu, he can click here and can see the menu things. So I have selected the items I wanted to place order for as a customer. So I will be clicking it here on the proceed. And after this, I will be reaching to the cart option, okay? So once I reach to the card option, it will ask me to choose the payment option we have available for debit cards, like PayStack and cash on delivery. So here at the moment, I will be choosing the cash on delivery. Also, I have another option to upload a prescription. If I have any prescription with me, I can click it here easily and I can upload it. Okay, just by allowing it everything. And here I got the option of camera, gallery, and PDF. So wherever the image has been saved, I can actually choose and upload it here. So let's begin with, let's click on order now and let's place order. And before all that, I need to a prescription. There's also an option to upload the prescription, so I will be clicking it here. And for example, I have prescription handy or in front of me. I can choose the camera option, and for example, I can take the image and I can upload it easily. So that's how we do it. And after uploading the prescription, let's click on order now. Okay, I also need to choose the payment option. I will be clicking on cash on delivery as a customer, and now I'll click on order now. So you will be able to see as a customer, I mean a customer will be able to see your order has been placed successfully. So so after this, a customer will reach to order details or order status page, I could say here, where a customer can actually see for which items the customer has placed order for, what is the payment, what is the total amount, number of items. Also, I could see the status of the order, like it has been placed, not been confirmed yet, and after that in store, on the way, so on. And if I will be scrolling it down as a customer, I would be able to see what is my order number, what is subtotal, what is tax, what is delivery charges, and the total amount. So let's go back to this. Okay, now let me just take you to the admin panel. So this is exactly the look of admin panel we have available. Okay, so the owner will be having their credentials. They can easily type those and click on login. After that, admin will be reaching out here to the admin panel, and this is what it looks like. It has many options such as like dashboard, catalog, supplier, agent, brands, orders, banners, promotion, notification, user, sub admins. So let's click on orders because we have recently placed two orders. Let me just remove. So if you can see, these are the number of orders which has been placed recently. So number one is a food order which I have which I have placed as a customer. I do have option to reject or confirm it as an admin. So as an admin, I will be clicking it on confirm and continue by default. My order has been successfully confirmed. And this is another option which I another order I could say, which I have placed as a customer. So I'm as an admin here, I'm confirming it, getting options to log in again. So let's go to the orders. This is my order. I can actually verify it from my order ID, which is 632. I can click on confirm, continue with default, order confirmed. So now let's go back to the customer application. So this is a customer application. I am back on it. So let's go to the orders. And here, if we go to the food one, so I can actually see my order is being confirmed at this time. Okay, and as a customer, I also will be receiving a push notification such as your order has been confirmed. You can actually see it from here. And let's go back, let's check out the another order. Customer can also check for this. So this was the order, and you can see it, the order is being confirmed. And as an admin, so once admin has confirmed the orders, that pending orders will directly move to the active one. And after this, the customer can change the status of the order. For example, like after confirm, admin can change it to in the kitchen, and customer will receive the notification like this, a push notification. Along with that, admin can actually assign this order to the delivery guy. So I'm assigning it to this delivery guy by choosing the name, and successfully it has been assigned. So my both orders has been admin. I have done a multitasking here, and as an admin, I have assigned my orders to the delivery guy. Okay, so now let's go to the delivery application, agent's application, I'm sorry, where you will get an idea like how the agent will get the notification and how it works. So this is the second one, is that application I'm talking about. The agent can actually log in through their social media accounts as well as by typing their email address and sign up as a name. So here I will be, we have essential agent. So agent can actually log in by filling their credentials. Let me just do that. As been agent, I'm trying to log in to my application, and here we go. So after logging, after putting the credentials, I can easily log in, and I could see what all orders have been assigned to me, and I can also see the history which orders I have done so far in the previous month or in the previous week as well. So let's back to the active one, the active orders I have available. So these are, the first one and the second one, if you can see. So these are the orders which have been assigned to me as an agent. I could actually click on any of these orders, and I could actually see by clicking few more details like what the order is all about. So order number, I can see the order number. I can see it's fully loaded wedge. I can see the price, and I mean as a agent, I can also click on directions to check like where I need to go to pick that order. So that's exactly the location. It will show me the location, entire location. So let's go back, and for example, like as an agent, I am agent, and I have reached to the restaurant to pick the item or to pick the order. I will be clicking. So once the admin has changed the status from ready to be picked up to on the way, so agent will get the notifications just like this. And if agent has already reached and delivered the product, so he can actually click here on delivered, and customer will get an push notification your order has been delivered successfully. So that's how the agent application works. And now if we talk about the admin panel here, so we also have option, let's discuss about the catalog. Customer, the admin of the application can add n number of services and n number of categories in catalogs. We have these options available like categories and groceries. We can click it here as an admin and add on the information such as like name, text, instruction, flow type, description of the product and services, and the images as well. After doing all those things, I will be just have to put on, I just have to click on next, and after this my services and my product will be listed automatically on the application. So how it works, so if somebody if admin wants to check the list of the suppliers, he can click here, and admin can have a look of all the suppliers which are listed here with their names, email address, their address, postal address, and their name. And after this, I can click on the agent option. I can see the number of agents I have available with their names and the commissions which are on which they are working on. After this, I can click on brands. I can see the brands I'm dealing in, the brands which I have listed as an admin. And after this, we have option of orders, this which we have already covered. This is the option for banners. I can actually create or customize any banners and list it or show it to my application, to my customers. After this, we have promotions. The same way, I can click it here. This is option to customize it. And I can customize it. I can also set up a date for specific dates. This will be automatically listed and screened on the application itself. After this, we have this notification tab, and if we click it here, I could actually see the notifications which I have recently got. And if I will be clicking on users, I could actually check the list here. So this is entirely the interface of the Gojek clone application we have available. And I hope you like my video, and if you have any more questions, hit me up. I am available.